Yeah, have I said excited a lot? I think that's why I hate. I'm not
you're excited.
We're excited.
We are now joined by multi-talented actor, singer, dancer, executive producer Sabrina Carpenter.
Keep going. No, thank you.
Sabrina, how is it? How is it going? You have a new movie out on Netflix, Work It. How excited are you about
this
new movie?
I never expected to be releasing a movie like this during this kind of a time period. And there's so much to take from it. And there's so many lessons and themes that people can hopefully find relatable to this current time right now.
What drew you to wanting to be a part of the film?
I mean, I always wanted to be a part of a dance movie. I grew up dancing in Pennsylvania from the time that I was around 2 years old. And I have three older sisters and my mom, who was a dancer.
I know we don't always see you in particular in those kinds of roles, so that was incredible to watch. And as
watch me dance poorly or
whatever.
You don't always get to dance.
Yeah.
I never wanted it to be too good though, because at the end of the day, like, I just didn't feel like someone that's that bad of a dancer could completely, I already know that people are gonna be like, wow, she learned how to dance overnight. And I'm like, no, I really wanted there to be a pretty natural like transition.
What was the rehearsal process like? Because obviously when there's so much dancing in a movie, that's a whole separate thing.
Probably at around 2.5 weeks to 3 weeks of strict dance rehearsals. Like, I couldn't always be there for certain rehearsals because I would be on set filming, but they were constantly rehearsing and changing choreography and changing songs. And it was something that kept us all really on our toes.
And we know that you have a song, Let Me Move You, on it. Was that always something you knew you were going to do, that you were always going to have a song?
After I watched Work It for the first time, my fellow producers came to me and they were like, can you write a song for the movie, like for the end credits? We need it in like a week. And I was like, what you want?
Okay.
I was like, any sort of direction? They were like, just do your thing. And I was like, cool. I wrote about 4 different songs and just like different directions, and Let Me Move You, like I would watch it with the end credits over and over, and it just put me in such a good mood.
How do you kind of prioritize what you want to work on, what projects you're kind of focused on at the moment with so many different lanes that you have put yourself in?
You know, even when it came into doing this project, like, I knew that it was going to take a lot of time and prep work and hard work, and it wasn't something that I could just do while I was doing other things at the same time, which is crazy because I ended up like having to shoot a video for Singular Act 2 while I was in Toronto filming Work It, like over the weekend. And like, you make those things happen as they come up. And so I think that that's how I've managed to balance it, is like not focusing too much on the past or the future, but just focusing on it day by day.
Are there any major or minor projects that you've been working on while you're in quarantine? Any music or anything like that?
I have another movie coming out in a couple months called Clouds, which I filmed in Montreal, and I'm like so excited for that movie as well. And it's the complete opposite of Work It. And I love when I'm able to do very, very different things and things that challenge me. And as I get older, it's like I'm continuously like dipping my toes in anything that I kind of can, but I'm always writing. Like, I'm so excited. There's so many songs that are going to be coming. I don't know when, and I can't say when.
And don't forget to subscribe to the Betches YouTube channel.